Is Mim? Oh, 8 tenths to look. Okay. Zero. Okay. Zero. And then a decimal. And then 8. That's exactly what 8 tenths would look like as a decimal. Okay? So that is what number 1 looks like. Alright? Number 2 and 3, when you're working on your math journals, are going to be done very similarly. Alright? We're going to go and skip to number 4 really quick. Okay? We're going to go to number 4. So it says, color part of the circle to show the decimal. Then name the fraction that is colored. All right? So again, how many pieces is our circle split into?
10.
10.
Okay.
Okay. And then it's asking us to color how many of them? How do we read this number?
1/10.
Okay. So if we need to color 1/10 and we have 10, how many of our pieces need to be colored?
1.
Excellent. Okay, so let's go ahead and color in one of them. Is that colored? Good. All right. Then our fraction, if we have 1 out of the 10 colored, how are we going to write our fraction 1/10? I need a hand raised. If you want to come show us on the board. One tenth look. Excellent. That is exactly what 1/10 would look like. So for number 4, number 5, and number 6 in your math journals are going to look very similar to this problem here. Okay. Now we're going to skip one more spot to number 7. Okay, we're going to work on number 7 real quick. And then when we're done going over this last example, you guys are going to get to split up into our groups, and then we'll work on them as our group. Okay, you'll go back and finish the problems we haven't done yet. Yep. All right. So just over here on number 7, it says choose greater than, equal to, or less than to make a true number sentence. All right. Our first problem here, number 7, says 2/10 is blank, 9/10. Okay. How would we fill this in right here? Mm-hmm. Less than. 2/10 is less than 9/10. Does everybody agree?
Yes.
Yes? Less than 9/10. All right. So that is how you'll do number 7 through 14 on your math journals. Once you have finished your math journal page, number 89, you're going to do math boxes on page 90. Okay? Before we do this, though, we're going to split up into our groups. Okay? Miss Springer, is there a certain area you would like to have your group work at?
I don't actually think I'm going to do it.
Okay? So we're going to have 3 individuals that are going with Miss Springer, Olivia, Chris, and Randy. You can go ahead and get your workbook and go ahead and go with Miss Springer now. Okay. And you're with Miss Baker's group. That is Clayton, Perry, Galaxy, Natalie, or Cooper. You're going to be back here at the horseshoe table. Okay. If you guys want to go ahead and get your books and your pencils and go ahead and move there now. And your name is Ben, Gabby, Isabella, Tyler, or Malia. You're going to be in my group. And we're actually going to be in my video camera. Sorry. Okay. We'll come work. Who are your girls? Okay. We're going to work here. Okay. And then Landon, Molly, Addison, Lily, and Harper. You guys can choose a partner if you would like and work together, or you can work on them individually. All right. So go ahead and move to those spots now. Yes, ma'am.
I'm waiting to see
what. Can you tell them? Yes, as long as you're working, that's fine. Okay. got our crew over here, Brittany, Gabby, Isabel, Tyler, and Malia.
I'll be right back. I need a whistling straight. Pay close attention if you are working on your own or with a partner on number six. Read the decimal as 4/10, but your fraction is only divided into fifths.
Okay. Question? Okay. You make it to 10, so how could you translate this into 10? So what would you do? So let's think about turning it into a fraction. What would you do to break this into a fraction? Yes. Times it by 2. So if you think it's top number times 2, the bottom number times 2, what do you have? 6. Can you write that as a decimal? Yep. There you go. See, that's what you're going to do. So anytime you run into that problem, you can always multiply it into fractions, and you can turn it into decimals from there. Does that make sense? All right. Yeah, you're Jeff. Sorry. Yeah, that's a question. All right. So one on number 2. Okay. How are you going to write that as a fraction? You Yes. So how did you turn, how did you get that to a six? Okay, good, because we did our 5 times 2, which gave us 10. And then we take 3 times 2, which is going to give us 6 tenths. That is our final answer there. Okay, for our fraction, or great, this is the right fraction too, but then how would you write 6 tenths in the decimal? How would you? Excellent. Excellent. So your decimal would look like 0.6. Your fraction can say 3/5. That's right. It can be 3/5 or it can be 6/5. They're both correct. Those are fucking fractions. You're going to probably run into a little trick on number 6 as well. Number 6 is kind of similar. Yes, you're going to do it. I'm going to write that down.
Number 3,
let me
look at number 3.
Your fraction is your decimal is no. Okay, let me help you figure out how to do this decimal.
So I have 5 of them.
You would, so our decimals have to be 10, correct? Right, if we have the decimal and then the first number is always in the tenth. How can we turn 3/5 as a fraction and the tenths as a decimal? Or as a fraction, let's stick fraction to fraction. We have 3/5. We're trying to get it over 10.
Okay, so I need 10 as my monitor. How do I get to 10 from 5?
I'll show you
what I need.
You're going to get this in the right position. Okay. We need to stay at the bottom.
5 times 2.
And then how do we turn the 5 here?
So here's my equivalent fraction. As for 10 as my monitor.
Yep. Because we're trying to find.
So go ahead and make this fraction equivalent to 6
times
2.
Okay, what is this fraction called? And then how can you write that as a decimal? Exactly. That's how
you guys wrote 3 and 5
tenths. It's a little tricky because it's got 2 steps to it. You have to take it from a fraction to an equivalent fraction and then to a decimal. Does that make sense?
6 tenths, how do I write
6 tenths? You have to get the denominator to be 10. It always has to get the denominator to be 10 to figure that out. Okay, so whatever you have to take it times, to get it to 10.
Ask
You did a good job on number six, Kendall. Six is a little tricky, but y'all did a good job on that.
Okay, well, on page 90 of my book, if you like it, I'll just have it okay. Are you done with number one?
Up and down, think about how tall you are, how wide you are.
So this one here is measuring, if you're looking at it from here to here, right? But you see how the circle is going from this side all the way around this one?
Okay, let's look up here.
Yeah, so it's telling you that big. So would that be a two, would that be a three, would that be a five?
Three times two, two, six. Make sure you show me the last circle. So on this one, make 10 my knowledge, how I get to my Good. Yep, so we're good.
Yeah, you go ahead and do your